Hello, so I'm just going to go through some basic interaction with Tidal. I'll assume that you've already installed Tidal. If you're still struggling with that, please ask questions. So you've already started SuperGlider, you've started SuperDirt running inside that, ready to make sound, and then you've opened Atom, ready to write some code in it, some Tidal code. So let's have a look at Atom. Right, so here we are. The first thing you need to do is save a file. So this is a new file. I'm just going to save it as interaction.tidal. There. So you can see that here it says Tidal cycles. And that's because I've saved the file as a .tidal file. You can call it whatever you want, but it has to end in .tidal. Okay, so let's start writing some code. I'll just do a simple kick drum, snare drum loop. So this BD stands for bass drum, so that's a kind of big kick drum, and snare drum is a kind of harsher sound. So let's play that. So it started with the kick drum there, and then continued with the snare drum, and it'll keep doing that forever. So if I to run a line of code, you just hold down Control and press Enter. It might be a different key if you're on a Mac, I'm not sure. But it'll be one of those meta buttons with holding down the Enter or Return, pressing the Enter or Return key. So that third time that I run it, it actually started with the snare drum instead of the kick. That's because it'll play this once per cycle, but those cycles are running all the time in the background. So it's just luck whether when I run it, the next event will be the snare or the kick. That takes a bit of getting used to. You might expect it to always start with the first thing. But because it's kind of live, it's time's always ticking up. You're just dropping these things in. There is a way of getting it so it'll always start with the start of the cycle, and we'll look at that later in the course. So here I'm running this line with Control and Enter, and then I'm stopping it by running this line, which says hush. This says D1 here, which kind of implies that there's also a D2, and that is the case. So let's try with a different sound, RP, just one of those. And then if I run this, that'll run at the same time. So now there's two patterns running together. And if I now run hush, that will stop both of them. You'll see that there's a blank line in between the two lines. That's quite important. So Control Enter will run a block of code, which is handy if you want to do something like add an extra line. So this will add a bit crushing sort of distortion effect. You can hear that's pretty distorted. So that you can see those two lines are flashing when I do Control Enter. I'll hush that. But now if I delete that line and then try and run it, it won't work. It'll come up with a horrible error. And that's because you have to always have this blank line. Otherwise, it'll try and run them together as a single pattern and just get confused. To be honest, this is a bit of a bug. Tidal should be able to work out what you mean. But that's the case at the moment, sorry. So remember to have a blank line between. Unless you just have loads of one-liners like this, you can instead hold down Shift and Enter, which will always only run the one line that your cursor is on. So let's try that. And that's fine. And then I can move down and run the RP. Yeah. So that works as well. I tend to just hold down, have that blank line and do Control Enter all the time. Because if I did Shift Enter here, there wouldn't be any bit crushing effect because it's only running that one line that I'm on. I'd have to do Control Enter to bring that second line in. Okay, so you'll just get used to adding this blank line and it'll be fine. What else? I think that's probably about it. We've just looked at remembering to put .tidal on the file, how to run things. Oh, actually, there's one more thing. If you have two things running, hash will stop them both, but if you want to just stop one of them, then you can just put D1 silence, for example. So let's try this in order. D1, then D2, got two things running. Now we've just got the second one running, and now we can do D2 silence. It doesn't matter where these commands are in the file. I can move this up here. It doesn't make any difference, so I can do the same thing. If you're used to programming in another language, you might be used to writing like a series of lines that get run together as a program. That's not the case here. You're just kind of having a conversation with Tidal, sending it bits of code. Tidal can't see the whole file. It just sees what you send it with control and enter. So you're actually sending that command and then stopping it with that. It's called a read eval print loop in computer speak, a REPL, which is just this kind of command line style of interaction. And you can see the command line here, but actually you're keeping all the code together in a file so that you can go back to it later and jump between different things, stopping them and starting them. Okay, I hope that was clear. If not, please ask questions. Questions are always very welcome. And see you at the next video. See you.